Welcome back, I'm Colin Daly. In part one of this video series, I demonstrated setting up IP communications between a CR1000X data logger, an RV50X cellular gateway, and a Modbus controller device. In part two, I will configure the data logger and the RV50X to communicate with external networks. To begin, I want to explain the different pathways or ports available for IP communications. All IP hosts have up to 65,535 access points, called ports, through which information can be sent and received. Some ports are designated for specific uses. I can use a house as an example of how IP ports relate to an IP host. A house has many ways to get things in and out, such as doors, windows, a mail slot, the water line, a gas pipe, fence, phone lines, power cables. However, just as pipes and cables in a house are dedicated to carry a specific type of thing, there are certain port numbers on an IP host that are dedicated to a specific type of communication protocol. For example, port 80 is used with the HTTP protocol. If an HTTP request comes in on port 88 instead of 80, the host won't know what to do with the request because it did not come in through the expected port. Here is a list of well-known ports in the network protocols they support. Port 6785 is important to Campbell Scientific data loggers because it is the default TCP/IP port used for packbus communications. Take a look at the network I set up in part one. Suppose I want to access the data logger webpage from the internet. I will have to go through the RV50X on a public connection, but specifying port 80 will have me accessing the RV50X port 80, not the data logger port 80 where the webpage is. This is where a service called port forwarding comes into play. I can set up a rule for the RV50X with the online configuration tool ACE Manager. ACE Manager is a built-in webpage in the RV50X used to configure the modem. It is accessible by connecting the RV50X to a computer with an Ethernet cable, then entering https://192.168.13.31 port 9443 into a web browser. In this case, we need to set up a rule that will forward incoming requests from outside the local network to specific nodes or hosts in the local network when the request comes in through a specific port. In this example, I'll set up two rules. The first will forward any requests coming in on port 80 to the internal address of 192.168.15.100 port 80, which is port 80 on the CR1000X data logger. Port forwarding must be enabled in the ACE manager for this to work. Requests for the data logger webpage that come to the RV50X from outside the local network will now be forwarded to the data logger, allowing the webpage to be viewed. The second rule will be to set up port 6785 on the RV50X to do the same thing. This allows a packbus device such as LoggerNet or another data logger to exchange data with a data logger in the private network behind the RV50X. For this to work, the IP address of the gateway device, in this case an RV50X, must be a public static IP address which allows two-way traffic through the modem between the data logger and an external network. With the IP address being public, make sure steps are taken to preserve the security of the connection. Public addresses may attract unwanted attention from unauthorized users looking for vulnerabilities. This can also lead to high data usage for the modem. A dynamic private IP address can be used, but only allows outbound communication from the data logger through the modem. Nothing from an external network will be routed to the data logger. However, this is a more secure option than a public IP address. To recap, an IP connection may be static or dynamic. A static connection allows two-way communications through the connection, while a dynamic connection is only one way from the data logger. A public connection can be discovered by other users. This means it requires additional security, such as a strong password to protect the data logger and data. A private connection cannot be discovered, so it remains less vulnerable to outside attack. A public connection may experience high data usage if it becomes the target of frequent outside contact. The dynamic connection, being undetectable, will only use data as the data logger sends information to the cloud or other destination. With an understanding of how IP addresses work, I will discuss using domain names to make devices with those addresses easy to find. When I tell someone the name of a website, I like to give a domain name that's easy to understand, something like campbellsci.com or axnr.connectgds.com. But computers and other network hosts don't recognize domain names. They require an IP address. To get the IP address, the computer needs to connect to a DNS server. A DNS server, or domain name system server, will translate the domain name into an IPv4 address, similar to how a person uses a telephone book. The DNS server locates the IPv4 address to the domain name so the connection can be made. Common DNS servers include 8.8.8.8 or 8.8.4.4 for Google and 208.67.222.222 for OpenDNS.com. Use the Device Configuration Utility to view the DNS servers a Datalogger uses. The DNS servers are found in the Advanced tab of the Settings Editor. Without the DNS server, a Datalogger has no way to resolve a domain name to an IPv4 address. Because Dataloggers can support multiple IP networks at the same time, one active IP interface is designated as the default interface. The default interface is usually the one that becomes active first on power-up. Typically, the Ethernet port becomes active first. But what happens when the Datalogger needs to connect to a device not connected to the default interface? In this example, the CR1000X is trying to connect to axonar.connectgds.com, the connect data service from Campbell Scientific. But since Ethernet is the default interface, the Datalogger attempts to connect to axonar.connectgds.com over Ethernet instead of PPP. This attempt will fail because the Datalogger connection to Axonar is through the PPP interface, not Ethernet. So, how do I tell the Datalogger to send messages bound for axonar.connectgds.com through the PPP interface instead of through the default Ethernet interface? I can use the IPRoute instruction in CR Basic to either change the default interface or specify which interface to use for specific outbound messages. The IPRoute instruction is used when an IP network other than the default network needs to be used. For example, by adding a line to the program stating IPRoute axonar.connectgds.com, 1, the Datalogger will use the PPP interface for the connection to Axonar rather than Ethernet. The second parameter sets the connection type. Since I want the PPP network, I'll choose 1. However, the default interface is still Ethernet, which means the Datalogger will still try to connect to the DNS server through the Ethernet connection first. There are a couple ways to correct this. The first is to include another IPRoute instruction for the DNS server in the CR Basic program, IPRoute 208.67.222.222, 1, tells the Datalogger to access the DNS server through the PPP interface. Alternatively, using empty quotes for the IP address parameter will set the selected port to the default interface. In this case, setting the second parameter to 1 sets PPP as the default interface. Now all network activity will default to the PPP interface rather than the Ethernet interface. If this option of setting the default interface to PPP instead of Ethernet is chosen, then I will need to change the second IP route from axonar.connectgds.com to the IP address of the PLC, 192.168.1.3, and also change the interface parameter to 0 for Ethernet. This tells the Datalogger to connect to the PLC through the Ethernet interface instead of the now default PPP interface. IPRoute adds a lot of flexibility for routing through specific IP interfaces, so I can choose the method that best suits my application. I've covered a lot in this video series. In summary, IP addresses have a network component and a host component. The network mask denotes which is which. Network masks for all hosts on a network must match. The network gateway is the host that provides access to hosts outside the network. The RV50X is a modem, router, and gateway that supports multiple IP networks and routes traffic between networks. Current Datalloggers support multiple IP networks as well, but are only able to route packet bus traffic. A gateway router is required to route IP traffic. All hosts have 65,535 IP ports through which traffic flows. Some of these are dedicated to specific protocols. Port forwarding and gateway routers and modems allows inbound IP traffic to be forwarded to the appropriate host on the private internal network. DNS servers are needed to resolve domain names to IP addresses. If a Datalogger has more than one active IP interface, use the IPRoute instruction in CR Basic to set the default network or specify the interface used to get to a specific IP address or domain name. Connecting a Datalogger to a network is a great way for sharing collected data. If you have any questions about IP networking, visit our website at campbellsci.com, read our product manuals, or speak to a Campbell Scientific representative.